Hey guys, Stealth here, and welcome back to another tournament match. Today, it's the fire-spitting Austro-Hungarians against the interesting design from the Russians. Only forward-facing firepower, but it is 15-inch. And if something gets closer, they got 8-inch to help them, as well as torpedoes. The Austro-Hungarians have those too, in large numbers. So let's see how well this is going to go for the Austro-Hungarians versus the Russians. Here we go. It's the Elizabeth Petsna class versus the Belarus class. Belarus Bowin, 15-inch guns, substantial firepower, but if somehow forced to turn because of, let's say, an incoming torpedo, or potentially because you've taken a lot of damage and you want to fall back in the formation, then you are going to find that that forward-facing firepower is all essentially useless. Once the ship starts turning at such an angle that the ship is unable to bring the guns to bear, then you're left with 8-inch guns, which aren't harmless. Absolutely not. They can still set fires, and potentially very quickly at that. But they're no 15-inchers. They don't have the same punch, they don't have the same damage capability. The Russians have shown that those 15-inch guns are dangerous. Laudon took 2 hits and has already lost 6% of her structural integrity. Now, the Austro-Hungarians have far smaller guns. They don't have 15s, they have 12s. And those reloads are very different. They only have a 16.2 second reload, meaning that these ships are spewing shells and shells and shells. As you can see by the distribution of shells, they very much favor high explosive, but the AI tends to go with AP first, which isn't necessarily the best option right now, because these AP shells, they're semi-armor-piercing shells. So basically, they don't do anything. You're going to cause a couple of partial pens. You won't likely get a full pen unless you find something that's really poorly armored. 18 clicks out. It might give you a deck pen. Might. But the chance for ricochets is really high. And I suspect you're going to get, let's say, 80% of the time, a partial pen. Now, the Austro-Hungarians also have a special feature on them. Torpedoes. Many, many torpedoes. They carry 15 launchers per side. So that's a total of 15 torpedoes per side they can put into the water. The real question with torpedo launchers is always A, do they work? And B, do they still work by the time that you're actually in range? Because the Russians are fighting at 17 kilometer range and these torpedoes only have 10. So all the while, as they close the distance, the Austro-Hungarian ships are going to take damage, which could translate into having lost torpedo launchers by the time that they're actually going to be useful. Here we go. Laudon has now fired high explosive, and so have the other two. It's just that their accuracy is so bad at this range. I don't really expect them to deal a whole lot of damage. Not yet. The Austro-Hungarians are also far better close-in warriors. They have a coincidence rangefinder, which works better at shorter ranges relative to longer ranges. So ideally, they would close the distance. Ideally, they want to fight at, I'd say, 10 kilometers, maybe less. Land a whole lot of high explosive onto a target and burn it down. If they can do that, they can very, very swiftly eliminate ships, as we have seen them do. If they are closing to, let's say, 9 or 8 kilometers, they can also use the torpedo launchers. The AI does not seem to want to launch those at maximum range. I don't know why, but the AI just doesn't. So they're going to have to close in. And they're kind of doing that already. They're 12-6, 12-5. And this Russian ship is more fire than ship at this point. So it's possible that they're going to use the excessive fire, sorry, extensive fire, and push this Russian ship out of the battle within 10 minutes. It's another 6 fires. 11 fires. Now, they're not coming out of this one unharmed, because the Pedznag has taken a lot of flooding. But rather a bit of flooding than a whole lot of fire. The starboard side of the ship's on fire. Port side's perfectly fine. Few more fires on her. Range? 11. 11-4. That's now down to 50% buoyancy. She has maximum bulkheads, only reinforced bulkheads 1. Interesting. Anti-flood 3. And unlocked delivery 5 engine, which is pretty high tier. That's going to mean that she's going to be able to take out those fires and floodings relatively fast, as compared to ships that just use, for example, auxiliary engine 2. You just get a nice buff to your ability to put out fires. On top of that, they're veterans. These guys have seen it all, been through it all, burnt everything down, and they have 60% bonus to damage control. And you can see that their accuracy is improving enormously. We're at 62%. But, yeah, no, they're still targeting the same ship. They're also inside a torpedo range. The Russians are about to lead a very interesting life. If the Austro-Hungarians use them. Because many a time I have seen torpedo launchers from AI ships point at other ships. Only to not use the torpedoes. They just don't launch. Don't know why. But it's something that they just refuse to do. Twelve-inch guns continue to set fires on what I can only expect to be the Belarus, because they always go after the namesake of the class first. The name giver. Now, if the Russians are going to get some divine intervention, it's going to be that the Austro-Hungarians get hit by the gunbug, where somehow they just cease fire. I don't know why it happens. It's a bug after all. It's really annoying when it does. Because you can suddenly have the match get completely turned around for really no good reason. Now, I've been going on about the torpedo launchers from the Austro-Hungarians, but the Russians have them too. They can hit out to 13.7 kilometers, and with that should not be discounted, especially when the Russians are broadside onto the target, because those torpedo launchers are underwater. You don't see them. You might not remember that they have them. But if the Russians get the opportunity, then they will remember for you. And they will send you about a 21-inch reminder that they have them. I wouldn't be surprised if we're soon going to be seeing a launch against the Laudon. Can she handle that? Oh yeah, she... More than. She has anti-torp 5. She has sonar 3. She'll not only see them if she does not turn out of the way, she will most likely shrug them off with anti-torp 5. She won't care that much. Oh, boy. Oh, good lord. Whose presents are those? Head's neck. Badly, badly damaged. And she's sending all of her torps against Irkutsk. And it's gonna hurt. Yikes. It's not so much the damage, the 3100. It's the fact that you now have flooding in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 compartments. So your buoyancy is going to take a big hit. And on top of everything, the Russians are forced to turn. This is exactly what I mentioned. Your 15-inch guns are useless now. Kronstadt is trying to swing around her guns as quickly as possible. Same for the Belarus. But this does mean that the Austro-Hungarian ships get some time to basically do damage for free. They're not trading fire. Well, they're trading fire, all right, but it's mostly them dealing the fire. Another 3 fires being set. They've lost 19% of the crew here. 0 there. 24 there. Yikes. Now, they do have a slight offset, if you will. They have 21% better damage control from being a regular trained crew. But they've also lost a bit of crew, meaning a bit of damage control capability. Who are you trying to torpedo? The Irkutsk? Bad call. Irkutsk is really struggling to control all that damage. She's on fire. She seems to be still flooding. Maximum bulkheads. Double hull bottom, reinforced bulkheads 2, anti-flood 3. She should be able to survive. Laudon is turning to port. Hard. I thought she was going to launch the torpedoes against the Kronstadt. Would have been a really bad situation for the Kronstadt to find herself in. Ah, there we go. The 15 inchers are now finally turned around. That can really hurt. Oh, it harmlessly sailed over the Laudon. At 4.5 kilometer range, they missed. Is that going to happen again? Nope, it's just a partial. It's really not that bad. Oh, come on, dude. You have the perfect shot here. Send the torpedoes. Use it or lose it in this case. Irkutsk. Wow. She was perfectly healthy. I think she had 94% buoyancy. Now she has 42. Good luck. Is she listing? That's another factor. I hadn't even considered that. It might not be so much that the ship is taking a whole bunch of damage and flooding. She might not even succumb to the flooding, but you can push her out of the battle by having her list. By causing a lot of flooding on the ship. Uh-oh. Are the Russians getting their divine intervention? Or are you switching targets? Austro-Hungarian ships are getting an angle warning when they're trying to target this ship. No, sorry, that's the Kronstadt. Kronstadt can't fire her guns. Is it going to be a battle of the secondaries now? Why are these guys not firing their guns? Nor their torpedoes, for that matter, but mostly not their guns. The Russians don't seem to have the same problem. Ooh. Laudon, you could have launched your port side against Kronstadt and your starboard against the other one a while ago. I'm not really sure where you're going, but you're getting in shotgun, absolute shotgun range of the Irkutsk. Maybe she's going to try and close the distance and launch the torps. That would be phenomenal, but it's the AI, so I kind of doubt it. Irkutsk can still torp, potentially. She is targeting the Petsnek, which is all the way back there. Curious. Come on, fire the damn guns! There we go. Maybe they just needed some motivation. They're so screwed here, the Austro-Hungarian ships. They're so close together that if one takes damage, the other one's likely to also take damage, or take damage for her. The AI really can't use torps. I do sometimes read the forums of this game, and I find it a bit frustrating that you can then see that they're working on fixing a gun position on a hull. People are reporting gun positions on hulls as being inaccurate. Or as, oh, this gun can't fire, and I'm going, yeah. If your one casemate gun of 4-inch can't fire, I don't really find that to be a priority over a whole section of 12-inch guns, primary armament that's just refusing to fire. That has a far more serious, a far more serious impact on gameplay than not being able to fire your frickin' 4-incher. This battle can still very much go either way. Oh, Belarus. Either floor it or get hit. Yeah, they're not going to floor it. That's gonna leave a mark. Yikes. 3 torps, 6 torps, 4.5k damage. Flooding from stem to stern. Another massive salvo. And the Messaggeri. I'm not sure what you're trying to hit. The Kronstadt? That one. How on earth do you think you're hitting that one? Oh, the Irkutsk is down. They burned her down. Belarus is going to have a very hard time controlling all that flooding. Petsnek still firing. I think by taking out one of the Russians, the Austro-Hungarians are far more favorable position now. Because once again, Belarus is on the defensive, trying to get out of torpedo range. Oh boy. Yeah, you're going to turn right into that, not out of that. Three torpedo hits. One of them was a dud. Two actuals. Flooding on four compartments. Fortunately, the torpedo blister did most of the prevention work there. And it looks like the Austro-Hungarians are very much on their way to burning down the Belarus. Torpedo detonation aboard. Here comes the big fanfare. Ronstadt seems to be on the run. Again, leaving her 15-inch guns out of this fight. Ah, the Russian design is interesting, right? It's not a... Oh boy. It's not a bad ship. It's just that the AI doesn't know how to use it. Belarus almost burned down. Those torps mostly won't do anything except for one, perhaps. There it is. 236 damage. Anti-torp 3 meets an 18-inch torp and goes, eh, fine. Whatever. Oh. You say the same? That one's harmless. I think the other one already sailed past. Where's Kronstadt going? Yeah, this thing is going to burn down. It's going to be real crispy very quickly. Especially with your damage control dwindling like this. The ship is rendered ineffective anyway. Her guns can't fire. She's too badly listing, and there she goes. Extensive fire. The Austro-Hungarians have done it again. Now, they came awfully close to losing one, potentially two ships there. But I think that unless the Kronstadt does something extensively stupid, they will be able to take this ship down as well. Kronstadt, as far as I'm concerned, should focus on the Petsnek. Eliminate the DPS, although arguably it's already eliminated, right? You don't really see any kind of lost DPS there, because she's not shooting. She's unable to. And I'm not sure what the Austro-Hungarians are doing. They're making some nice, funny little circle. But it doesn't seem to be doing them a whole lot of work. I mean, they're just... turning? Non-stop? I think what's happening here is two systems are working against each other. One is trying to use the formation. Two is the avoid system. Make sure you try to avoid collisions, which is what they're constantly trying to do. And on top of that, they constantly keep switching who's boss. Now it's Loudon, now it's Petsnek. So the this is turning into a big cluster bug. You had the we're not shooting bug. And now you have the I don't know who's boss bug. Oh, come on. By some miracle, they're still able to fire. Although, this one, badly, badly flooded. No torpedo launchers available. Not there either, but the Petsnek has torps. And they're ready. Oh, if the Kronstadt could stay at range, she might be able to take them all down. Not what she's doing, though. But the Austro-Hungarian DPS is gone. Oh, this could be much, much, much closer than I thought. There goes one. Now you really need to switch fire. No, 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 no. Not necessarily to that one. Oh, they burned her down. The Austro-Hungarians did it again. Toasty, toasty, toasty. They did lose a ship, but they did sink all three of the Soviet Union's warships. So that means points for Austria-Hungary. I don't exactly like the way they're going about getting the points, but it is a valid tactic. I hope the devs work a bit harder on fixing, let's say, the meta game issues which is burn anything down, anything goes, rather than fixing barbed positions. But we'll see how it goes. Anyway, with this, the standing is that Austria-Hungary has won 2 games and lost nothing. Are they going to meet their match? Perhaps. They still have to fight Spain. Spain is coming up next and it's won once and it's lost once. Beyond that, they still have to fight Japan. That's going to be a very interesting one because Japan, I think, favors staying at range. Well, the design of the ship does. Whether the AI does, probably not. We'll see how it goes. First up, though, US versus France. These 16-inch guns from the France... From the French against the 13-inchers from the US. Let's see how that's going to go. Hope you guys enjoyed the tournament so far. We are approaching the last couple of rounds. And after that, it's on to the finals. And so far, I don't really have any specific predictions yet. Because the UK is doing well. Germany is doing quite well. Austria-Hungary might make it in there. We'll just have to see. Hope you guys are enjoying it. Thank you for watching. Let me know what your thoughts are down below. And I'll see you soon for more.